Hello and welcome to Vinsloev Academy. This is part 2 in our network basics series. If you haven't seen part 1, please find it either in the site or go to our channel. So in part 2 we'll be discussing IPv version 4 and IP version 6 and why we need a new version and what is the difference between these two. So first of all, IP addresses. IP addresses is logical addresses, meaning that they are not hard-coded into our network card and they can thereby be switched from day to day, meaning that the IP address that one of your devices have today maybe not be the address that it has tomorrow, because your router may be giving another device that IP when your device disconnect from the internet. And also the IP address that you have at your internet service provider can also be changed, but that is a bit more difficult to do. So as you see in the picture right here, we have different IP addresses. We have our IPv4 address, which is this one right here, and we have our IPv6 address right here. And as you see, there is a clear difference between the two of them. So we're going to see what that difference is. But first of all, you need to understand that there are public and private IPs. So the private IPs are the ones that are internally in your network. So if you have a computer or any device connected to your router at your home, they all have a private IP, meaning that it is your router that gives out these IPs. And most likely these IPs will look like this right here. As we see, we have these two computers and they share similar addresses, where this is ending at 100 and this is 101. And then all the traffic internally on your network is controlled by your router based on the IPs that has been distributed in the DHCP. Then we have the public IP, which is the one that is showing outside to the world. So this is the IP that the internet web pages that you visit will be having in their logs when you're connecting to them, or whoever you communicate with on the outside will see this IP, because this is your public IP given to you by your internet service provider. So this is the difference between the public and the private IP. So if you do a scan on your network and see all these internally IPs, and then you go to the whatsmyip.com or some similar site, you will see that even though you see that your computer have this address, this is the one that is getting showed to the outside world. But let's get into the IP versions. This is IP version 4, which is the old version, and it is currently being changed so that it will be moved over to IPv6 on the wider internet and not necessarily internally. Because an IPv4 version consists of 32-bit addresses, meaning that we have 32 bits, and that is because our computers can only understand binary language, meaning ones and zeros, where if you have a 1, meaning that it is on, 0, it is off. Similar to your lightning switch, it can be on and off, and that is really down in the basic what a computer understand. So an IPv4 address is divided into 4 sets of 8 binaries. So for example, this is a IP address, and this right here correspond to an address similar to this one, because this has been translated into the numbers, whereas these represent the binaries. So this is down to the basic binary address of our IPv4 version. So let's have a look at how this is translated from clear binaries into the 4 sets we saw before. So now we have our binary address right here with four set of 8 binary. Then we're using this little template to translate it into the numbers that we saw in our address, and which is the ones we are seeing when talking about IPv4. So we just take these binaries, add them into this right here. I'll just make it a bit smaller, like so. Then we simply just say 1, because the first one is 1. Then we say 1. Then we have a 0. Then we have a 1. And a 1, and we have a 0, and the last 2s are 1s as well. So now these right here match the first set of 8 right here. Then what we have to do is simply just to add these together. So we simply just say 180 plus 64 plus 16 plus 8 plus 2 plus 1, and that's equal to 219. So this is the first number, so this is going to be 219 dot, and then the next group and the next group and next group again, we do the similar thing. So an example will be that we just end up with something like this. Oh, like so. So this could be an address that we could end up if these were the right numbers. This is just an example, so this is not what is going on here, but you can try it on your own and calculate the exact address of the last 3 sets. We can, however, also go in the opposite direction. So if we remove this, and let's say we didn't know this binary right here, but we only have this IP and we needed to know what kind of binary group or set would we have, then we simply just take 219 and let me just remove this one. Like so. And then we simply just say 219. Can 219 be within 128? Yes, it can. And then we simply subtract 128 from 219. Then we say, can 64 be within the value that we have left? And again, it can. And now we say, can 32 be within this value? It cannot, because we have already subtracted 128 and 64, so this will be a 0. And then again, we say, can 16 be within the value that we have left? It can. Can 8 be within the remaining value now that we have subtracted both 128, 64 and 16? It can. Can 4 be in the remaining value? But as this is 3, it can't, so this will be a 0 as well. And then 2 and 1 can be within this. So this is the way that you can calculate the values in both directions. So now it's time to look into what the problem set is with the current IP version 4. So now that we have seen what the IP version 4 look like, it's time to talk about the problems with it. The problem with this IP version is that as it is a 32-bit address, it is only possible to have 4 billion different addresses. And as the world get more and more devices connected to the internet, we now not only have computers, we have webcams, we have kitchen tools, we have cars and robots, and all kind of different stuff is getting connected to the internet, meaning that the current version simply not have enough unique IPs, and we can't generate enough unique addresses out of this 32-bit address, which is IPv version 4. So the world needed something new, and that is where IP version 6 comes into play. So as you might remember from the first slide, we saw an IP version 6, which is this one right here, and instead of being of 32 bits, this is 128 bits, and it is based on hexadecimals, and we can have trillions of unique addresses in this 128 bit address range, because each of these characters is based on a 4 binary group. And we will head over again to see how such is generated in hexadecimal. So now to how we can calculate the hexadecimal IPv6 address based on the binary. So as we see right here, we have the first group of FE80, which is the one that we are going to try to calculate with the F. So as we see right here, we have the decimal right here, and we have the hexadecimal right here. So from 0 to 9, these are equal, so 00, 44, 88. But when we get to 10, then the hexadecimal is going to be A, 11B, and so forth down to 15, which is F. So the way that we can calculate this in binary is similar to what we learned before. So we can say f is 8 within f, which corresponds to 15. Yes, it is. So we will say 1. Then we subtract 8 from 15. And then we say, is 4 within this value? Again, yes, it is. And then we can do that for the rest. And since f is the largest value and these equals 15, we can just add the last ones and ones. So now we know that the first binary set of this hexadecimal group is going to be 1111, corresponding to the f. And then we can do that for each of the values. And then to illustrate another example, now we could just say 111, and then the next value, let's just delete this, and the next value will be e. So let's see e, and that corresponds to the value below here, so that will just be 1110, because we are missing the last value from 15. So that will be, let's see right here, that will be 1110, and then we have an 8, and that is 8, so that will just be 1, and then the rest will be 0, so that is 000, and then we have a 0, meaning that it is 40, so 0000. So this value right here is the binary format of this first four characters right here. So that is why the IP version 6 can have so many addresses, because there are so many more opportunities to have unique addresses within this address space of 128 bits. Then one last thing to be aware of is this double colon right here. So if you see an address, for example what we have in the picture, and then colon like this, and then it continues, then it means that, because as you see right here, this is not 128 bits, because the address is much longer if it is filled with all the values. But when we have two colons like this, this means that from this point on onto the next point right here, it should just be filled with zeros, and that is done for us to not have such long addresses. But we can utilize this feature just to remove all the zeros from the address space. But our computer will know that there should be the remaining values up to 180 bit. When looking at this length, it should just be filled with zeros. So this was IPv4 and IPv6. I will see you next time here on Vinsloev Academy.